island is amazing. What to know about traveling in Bonaire, coming up. Ooh, this video is for someone who doesn't really know a lot about Bonaire or is curious about traveling here. Let's start with the location. Bonaire is a part of the ABC Islands, and it's actually located close to Venezuela. And one thing that I didn't know until I got here is that it's owned by the Netherlands. And so the primary language that I'm hearing people speak around the island is Dutch, but also the common language here, which is a Creole language, Papiamento. This island is actually not that big. It's 24 miles long and about 5 miles across, so it's actually pretty small. If you look at the map, you'll see that the amount of main roads that there are not that many, but there are around 20,000 people that live on the island, and tourism is a really big thing here. How about the weather? We'll talk about that. The weather's actually really amazing year round because this spot is like 81 degrees all the time, which is amazing. But you can see it's also pretty windy here, which is why windsurfing and kite surfing, aside from diving, is one of the biggest things to do on the island. But it's cool because this Caribbean island isn't affected by hurricanes. It's outside of the hurricane belt, which is pretty amazing. But the wettest months are October through December. Which, by the way, yo, I never introduced myself. I'm Christine, and this is Where in the World is CL, and I make travel videos every week to help you get up, get out, and get traveled. So if you like to travel, consider subscribing. Look how amazing these salt flats are behind me. Isn't that cool? So I talked about windsurfing, and that's the top thing to do on the island, but the number one thing to do on this island is scuba diving, and specifically shore diving. This is one of the best destinations in the Caribbean for shore diving, and there are literally almost 100 dive sites on this island. It's spectacular. I've been diving this entire week. Alice in Wonderland was one of my favorite spots, but if you want to see more about what diving is like on this island, check out my other video, link in the description below, and dive in with me. If you watch my channel, you know I chase a lot of beaches and a lot of islands around the world, but this one is really, really unique to me for a few reasons. The first is because you kind of have a long stretch of nothing on this island, which is amazing because I feel like I have the island to myself, even though right now when I'm traveling here in August 2021, supposedly this island is jam-packed. I wasn't able to get any tours, and a lot of the restaurants require reservations because it's so busy. But literally, it feels empty, and it's awesome. The second is because you can see some really unique animals on this island. There's a huge flamingo population, and there's also a lot of donkeys here, which is kind of neat. There's a donkey sanctuary and the flamingo sanctuary, but they also have, and you saw it a second ago, the salt flats, which are just so stunning to look at. One of the other things that's amazing about traveling here is that as an American, it is so easy to travel here. Which, by the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, cheers that like button, consider subscribing, and make sure you check the description for more helpful info. But the reason why it's so easy to travel here as an American is because they speak English here, and you can pay in US dollars, which is makes it really easy. I'm driving on the right side of the road. Granted, most rental cars are manual. And you can drink the water. Bonaire's seawater is purified, and it's some of the best drinking water in the world. But you know I love to keep it real, and one of the things I'll be honest about is that traveling here relative to other places I've been this year, and if you look on my channel, I've been to Zanzibar, I've been to Holbox Island, I've been to Cancun, I've been to Isla Mujeres, I've been to blah, blah, blah. And basically, this is one of the more expensive destinations I've been to. You can, from the US, find flights around $300 to $400 round trip, and there are a lot of direct flights, but I, during this high season, my flight was just over $750, and I would say relative to other places around the world, things are a little bit more expensive. For more things I was surprised by, come join me in my next video and I'll share some of those with you, but I hope you had some fun with me in this video. Cheers that like button if you haven't already, and I'll see ya in the next adventure. Ciao.